So let's start it. I'm sharing my screen. So we were discussing vector algebra, right? And I gave you problems as homework from exercise 10.2. So I hope you all solved it. And is there any doubt? Is there any problem which was tough? Yes or no?
Okay.
So assuming that this exercise is over, since there are no doubts from your side, I'll go to the next exercise. That is, you're going to see how to find the product of two vectors. Till 10.2, we were seeing the sum of two vectors and the difference of two vectors. In the next exercise, we'll be concerned about how to find the product of two vectors. So there is no concept like division of vectors, okay? So product of two vectors is going to be the last part. In this, there are two kinds of products that we are going to perform. One is called as scalar product and the other is called as vector product. Okay. So in this exercise, we are going to be concerned about the scalar product. Okay. The name for scalar product is, it is also called as dot product of two vectors. Let's see what it means. So if I give you two vectors A and B, if A vector and B vector are given, what are all the mathematical operations you can perform between them? You can perform A vector plus B vector, or you can perform A vector minus B vector. Similarly, when you talk about multiplication, unlike the way we multiply the numbers, with respect to vectors, what we do is we take the directions also into consideration and we have to multiply them accordingly. Okay. So that is why, if you see, the product of vectors is basically classified like this. Scalar, and the second is called as vector product. So scalar product is also known as dot product, and vector product is also known as cross product. Let's see what are the difference. So in this exercise, our main concept of discussion will be scalar product. So listen, it is like this. If two non-zero vectors A vector and B vector are given, then the scalar product between them is defined as A vector dot B vector is equal to magnitude of A vector into magnitude of B vector into cos of the angle between them, cos theta. So this A vector, B vector, this is written as A vector dot B vector is equal to, this is magnitude of A vector, this magnitude of B vector, and theta represents the angle between both vectors. Okay. So this is how the definition goes. Make a note of this. So A vector dot B vector is equal to magnitude of A vector into magnitude of B vector cos theta. Okay, now see. So that is how the definition is given. Right? Where theta can be any angle between 0 to pi radians. Okay. if suppose, see, there's a case which is known. If A vector is zero vector or B vector is zero vector, then theta is not defined. And in this case, we can define A vector dot B vector is equal to zero, because either of the vectors is going to have zero magnitude. That is the output. Now see, if suppose A vector is given as, let's say A vector is A1 I cap plus B1 J, A1 I cap plus A2 J cap plus A3 K cap, and B vector is equal to B1 I cap plus B2 J cap plus B3 K cap. Okay. Then how do we find the dot product between them? For example, if I give you vectors like this, I cap plus J cap plus K cap, and B vector is equal to I cap minus J cap plus K cap. So I've taken two random vectors. If I ask you to add them, what will you do? So A vector plus B vector will be equal to, you will add the coefficients of I cap. That will be 2 I cap plus 2 K cap, because J cap will get cancelled, right? That is A vector plus B vector. Similarly, you can do the subtraction. In a similar context, if I ask you to do the dot product between them, what are we going to do is the question. So observe. So it is A1 I cap plus A2 J cap plus A3 K cap dot B1 I cap plus B2 J cap plus B3 K cap. Right? So when you do the dot product between them, it will be, it is like normal multiplication only, except the fact that between vectors we need to do dot multiplication. Okay? Observe what I'm going to do. A1 is a scalar quantity, B1 is a scalar quantity. Right? So A1 is a scalar and B1 is a scalar. You have three terms here and three more terms here. When you multiply three terms into three terms, you are totally going to get nine terms, right? Out of those nine terms, the first term will be A1 into B1. So between scalars, I'm doing normal multiplication. But what are the vector parts associated with these scalars? That is I cap. And here you have an I cap. So between these two I caps, we need to do a dot product. Okay, I cap dot I cap. Plus, what will be the next term? A1 B2 into I cap dot J cap. Plus A1 B3 I cap dot K cap. Plus A2 B1 into what? What should I write? A2 B1?
J cap dot I cap.
Yes. J cap dot I cap plus A2 B2 J cap dot J cap plus A2 B3 J cap dot K cap plus A3 B1 K cap dot I cap plus A3 B2 K cap dot J cap plus A3 B3 K cap dot. So I hope it is clear. So totally how many terms did we obtain? We got nine terms, right? Now for those nine terms, we need to see what is going to be the output. Observe. If I give you I cap dot I cap, that is the first term we have, right? I cap dot I cap. What is it going to be? Here I cap is A vector. Here this I cap is B vector. This is according to the definition, okay? Not this A vector and B vector, okay? So according to the definition of dot product, what will you have? If you have A vector dot B vector, it is magnitude of A vector into magnitude of B vector into cos theta, right? To put it in simple terms, first vector dot second vector is equal to, let's forget about A and B as of now. Have this in your mind. First vector dot second vector is equal to magnitude of first vector into magnitude of second vector into cos theta, where theta is the angle between them. So in a similar case, it will be magnitude of I cap into magnitude of I cap into cos of, what is the angle between I vector and itself?
Zero.
So zero. So magnitude of I cap is one because it's a unit vector. Magnitude of the second I cap is also one, and cos zero is also one. That is going to give you one, right? So that is why when you do I cap dot I cap, the answer is going to be one. Similarly, can I say j cap dot j cap will give you a 1 and k cap dot k cap will also give you a 1. Whereas what happens with respect to I cap dot j cap? It is going to be magnitude of I, yes, magnitude of I cap into magnitude of j cap into cos of, what is the angle between them?
90 degrees.
So answer will be 0. So what are all the products that you get cancelled? I dot k will be 0. Sorry, I dot j will be 0. I dot k will be 0. J dot I will be 0. J dot k will be 0. K dot I will be 0. K dot j will be 0. So out of the 9 terms, 6 terms get vanished. So what is that you are left out with? So the final product that you will be left out with is A1 B1 into I cap dot I cap is 1 plus A2 B2 into J cap dot J cap is 1. Similarly, A3 B3 into K cap dot K cap is 1. So this is going to be A vector dot B vector, which is nothing but the product of what? The coefficients of I cap plus the product of the coefficients of J cap plus the product of coefficients of K cap. So this is how you get the final answer. Make a note of this. I hope you're done.
1 minute, sir.
So based on this, we will do a small example. If A vector is I cap minus J cap minus K cap, B vector is equal to 2 I cap plus 3 J cap plus K cap. Then if I ask you what is A vector dot B vector, it is very, very simple. Look at the coefficient of I cap in the first, coefficient of I cap in the second, multiply them. So answer will be 1 into 2 plus minus 1 into 3 plus minus 1 into 1. So answer will be 2 minus 3 minus 1. So 1 minus 3, answer will be minus. So this is the dot product of these two vectors. So the reason why dot product is also called a scalar product is because when you do the dot product between two vectors, the output will be a number. It will be a number with a sign. So the output is coming out as a scalar. That is the reason why we call it as a scalar product also. Done?
Yes, sir.
Now listen. Now we'll see certain properties of dot product. So you can, what are all the observations? So if you do the dot product between A vector and B vector, it is a real number. It's a scalar quantity. Okay. Similarly, if A vector and B vector be two non-zero vectors, and if you say A vector dot B vector is zero, that is possible only when the two vectors are perpendicular to each other. So write it down. Write down the properties of dot product. If two non-zero vectors are perpendicular to each other, then the dot product between them is zero. Then A vector dot B vector is equal to zero. Next. So we know that A vector dot B vector is equal to magnitude of A vector into magnitude of B vector cos theta. From this we can conclude that cos theta is equal to A vector dot B vector divided by magnitude of A vector into magnitude of B vector. This is another important relation. So why I am saying it is important is because sometimes, by the way, I hope you understood why the dot product between two perpendicular vectors is zero, right? So I hope everyone is clear with the first property. It is because theta will be 90 degrees and cos 90 is zero. That is the reason why dot product is zero. In the second case, what will happen is I have just done a small manipulation. A vector dot B vector is equal to magnitude of A into magnitude of B into cos theta. Then cos theta will be A vector dot B vector by magnitude of A into magnitude of B. So what they will do in the question is, they will give you two vectors and ask you, how are these two vectors aligned with respect to each other? Aligned in the sense, what is the angle one vector is making with respect to another? Okay. So how we can do is, let's go with the same example. So I'm taking an example. Find angle between the vectors A vector is equal to I cap minus J cap minus K cap and B vector is equal to 2I cap plus 3J cap plus K cap. Okay. Then what is cos theta between them? Cos theta will be A vector dot B vector divided by magnitude of A vector into magnitude of B. So which implies cos theta is equal to, so what is the dot product between these two guys? So how you do the dot product between them? We already did it. And what was the answer we got? We'll do it
minus
again.
Two, sir.
Yes. 2 into minus, sorry, 2 minus 3 minus 1, the whole divided by. What is magnitude of A vector? It is square root of coefficient of I cap square plus coefficient of J cap square plus coefficient of K cap square. So 1 square plus minus 1 square plus minus 1 square. Okay. What will be the magnitude of B vector? That will be root of 2 square plus 3 square plus 1 square. So what is cos theta? Minus 2 divided by, what is this case? It is root 3 into root of 4 plus 9, 13, 13 plus 1, 14. So minus 2 divided by root 42. So what will be the value of theta? Theta will be cos inverse of minus 2 divided by root 42. I hope you are able to understand.
Yes, sir.
Make a note of this. I hope it is done. So second property we have seen. Similarly, the third one is also very important. If theta is equal to 0 degrees between them, means what kind of vectors are they?
Parallel vectors.
They can either be parallel or collinear, right? They can either be parallel or collinear. Then A vector dot B vector will be equal to magnitude of A vector into magnitude of B vector cos theta. Right? This is the basic definition. So it is going to be magnitude of A vector into magnitude of B vector cos 0. So it is simply A vector's magnitude into B vector's magnitude. This is a simple concept. See, while you are solving many problems, no, you will have a scenario where you will do the dot product of the vector with itself. Similarly, what is A vector dot A vector? It is magnitude of A vector into magnitude of A vector into cos 0. Okay, into cos 0 degrees. So this will be magnitude of A vector square into cos 0. Or you can simply write it as A square. So you will see this kind of an expression in many places. So wherever you are seeing A square, where A is a vector, then it means the vector is multiplied with itself using dot product. That is the meaning. Okay, we'll be using it in many places. Please make a note of this. This is very, very important. Okay. The fourth property. The fourth is, see, theta is equal to pi, you know, cos 180 is going to be minus 1. Okay. So if at all you have minus a square, it means the vector is multiplied with the negative of its vector. So there is a similar property. There is nothing much to discuss about this. Similarly, this part I have already explained. And this one I have explained. Next important is scalar product is commutative. That is, A vector dot B vector is equal to B vector dot A vector. And they have put a question why. The answer is simple. It is because cos of minus theta is cos theta. That is the reason. Okay, next. So some more properties of scalar product are its distributive property. So distributive property over addition. If A vector, B vector and C vector are any three vectors, then the dot product of A vector with the sum of the other two vectors, B vector and C vector, will be A dot B plus A dot C. Okay. Similarly, if A vector and B vector be any two vectors and lambda be any scalar vector, then if you multiply lambda with A vector and do the dot product with B vector, it is the same as lambda times A vector dot B vector is the same as doing the dot product of A vector with lambda times B vector. All the three are same. Okay. After this, there is a derivation which I have already explained it to you. Okay, so these are all some major points related to dot product. Tell me one thing, is there any doubt? Is there any point which is not clear for you guys still here?
No doubt.
No doubt. Okay. I think we can go to the next concept. So the next concept is called as projection of a vector on a line. See, this concept is important in this chapter, and it is more important than next chapter. Okay, so you need to understand what exactly projection means. So if you read the topic, they are saying projection of a vector on a line. What is the meaning of this? Let's first try to understand projection. Okay. Listen. So before I explain what is the projection of a vector on a line, let me explain this concept. So we know what is a line, right? So line is a one-dimensional shape which gets extended in both the directions. Now, if you have a line segment AB, okay, I'm repeating it. It's a line segment AB. If I say you need to project AB on this line L, then the meaning of this is, listen to it carefully. From the starting point of A, you need to drop a perpendicular onto the line L. Similarly, from the ending point of the line segment AB, you need to drop a perpendicular onto the same line L. When you do this, you get 2 foot of the perpendiculars. Let's say the foot of the perpendiculars are PQ. Then this distance PQ is what is called as projection of AB on line L. So projection means it is the distance between 2 foot of the perpendiculars drawn from the ends of a line segment onto a line. That is the meaning. Am I clear with this?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now I will slightly change the concept. So, but here it is not the projection of a line segment on a line, rather they are trying to call it as a vector, right? So when that is a vector, observe. If I make it as a vector, then can I say, if I extend this virtually and this line also, then there is some angle theta existing between them, right? We can clearly understand from the diagram that AB, the vector AB, is not parallel or perpendicular to the given line L. It is making some angle. Let's say that angle is theta. Then if I draw a virtual line like this, if I do a small construction, see the construction, I'm doing it with red color. If I do a small construction like this, then can I say this angle is also theta? So the distance AB is called as magnitude of AB vector. Accepted? Right. So if I call this distance as X, then what is X divided by magnitude of AB vector?
Cos theta.
It is cos theta, where theta is the angle between them. So from this, can I conclude X is equal to magnitude of AB vector into cos theta? Okay. Are you guys able to understand this? So then this X is what is called as projection of a vector on line. We did nothing. We just made small construction, formed the right angle triangle, applied the definition of cos theta. Okay. So wherever you see projection, it is related to cos theta. Remember this in your mind. Okay. Have this in your mind. What I'm going to do is, we will see how to find the projection of one vector on another. Okay. So observe. Suppose the line, on the line L, there are 2 points P and Q. If I represent the if I represent the line segment PQ as a vector, okay. See, observe what I'm going to do is, This is AB vector. Right. So if this is the line, if I drop a perpendicular, then if I call this distance as P, where P is the projection. Okay. Okay. Now observe. If I take this as theta, so I'm just following the textbook. Observe. If P cap is a unit vector along the line, then the projection of A vector on the line is given by A vector dot P vector. Why it is so, we will try to understand. Okay. So if the projection is taken as P and the direction of it is taken as P cap. I hope you know the difference between both, right? Projection is the magnitude. P cap is the direction. Right. Then, can I write this vector as, observe. Can I write this as P times P cap? Did you guys understand what I did? I wrote PQ in the form of a vector. So PQ vector, I wrote it as its magnitude times its distance. Like how I told you when I explained unit vector, A vector is nothing but magnitude of A vector times A cap. From here you got A cap is equal to A vector divided by magnitude of A vector. I did the same thing, only difference is variable is different. So PQ vector is equal to P dot P times P cap. I hope this point is clear, right? Now, so how to find the dot product between these two vectors? So cos theta, sorry, how to find the angle between these two vectors? Angle between the vectors, I told you a method. It is A vector dot B vector, that is first vector dot second vector divided by magnitude of first vector into magnitude of second vector. Right? So cos theta is equal to first vector dot second vector, the whole divided by magnitude of first vector into magnitude of second vector. Okay, I'm waiting. Our work is not to find the magnitude. So if I take this point, if this distance is P, then we already proved that PQ is equal to magnitude of AB times cos theta. That is what we wrote. So X is equal to magnitude of AB times cos theta, where that X is taken as P. Right? So in this case, I've taken PQ as P. What is the magnitude of AB vector? It is AB vector only. Then what is cos theta, guys? Cos theta is equal to AB vector dot PQ vector by magnitude of AB vector into magnitude of PQ vector. I hope this point is clear to you guys. Yes or no? Did you understand what I did? So here AB vector and AB vector will get cancelled. So P will be equal to, if AB vector is taken as A vector, then A vector dot, what is PQ vector guys? It is P times P cap, the whole divided by magnitude of PQ vector is P. Accepted? So this and this will get cancelled. So what can you write? A vector dot P vector. So that is the reason why they wrote it like this. Okay. Am I clear? Make a note of this. So From this, look at the way I'm going to write. This is one way of writing, or I can write it as A vector dot P cap can be written as P vector divided by magnitude of P vector using the same logic. Unit vector is vector divided by its magnitude. Accepted? So the meaning of this is projection of A vector on P vector. Okay. Projection of A vector on P vector is given as A vector dot P vector divided by magnitude of P vector. So from this, I'm going to give you a general formula. Projection of AB vector on CD vector. Okay, AB is one vector and CD is another vector, is given as the dot product between them, AB vector dot CD vector, divided by the magnitude of the base vector. That is the second vector. Whatever vector is there after this on, that vector's magnitude will be taken in the denominator. Is it clear? So make a note of this. Now see, I'm going to the next concept. So with this, the concepts are over. So next we are going to discuss problems. So the first question is example 13. Find the angle between the two vectors A vector and B vector whose magnitude is 1 and 2 respectively when A vector dot B vector is equal to 1. So it's an easy problem. So cos theta is equal to A vector dot B vector divided by magnitude of A vector into magnitude of B vector. So A vector dot B vector is 1 divided by magnitude of A vector is 1 and the magnitude of B vector is 2. So 1 divided by 2 will be the answer. So theta will be equal to cos inverse of half. So what is cos inverse of half?
5/3.
So 5/3 is the required answer. I'm going to the next one. Yes. So second one is find angle theta between the vectors A vector is equal to I cap plus J cap minus K cap. B vector is equal to I cap minus J cap plus K cap. Okay. So what is cos theta again? Cos theta is equal to A vector dot B vector divided by magnitude of A vector into magnitude of B vector. That will be, so what is A vector dot B vector? 1 minus 1 minus 1, the whole divided by magnitude of A vector is root 3. Magnitude of B vector is also root 3. So 1 minus 1 minus 1 is minus 1 by 3. So theta will be equal to cos inverse of 1 by 3 with a negative sign. Either you can leave it like this or you can write it as pi minus of cos inverse of 1 by 3, because we know that cos inverse of minus x is pi minus cos inverse of x. So this is the final answer. So I'm going to give it fast because these are all simple problems. Now listen. This is an important question. See, this is a good one. If A vector and B vector are given like this, then show that the vectors A plus B and A minus B are perpendicular to each other. So what are the condition for perpendicularity? So what is the condition for two vectors to be perpendicular to each other?
Dot product is zero.
So their dot product should be equal to zero. But here, they are not asking us to prove that A and B are perpendicular. Rather, they are asking, what is to be proved?
A plus B.
A plus B dot A minus B as vectors is equal to zero. This is what we need to prove. So for that, let's first find out what is A vector plus B vector. Tell me, A vector plus B vector is 6 I cap minus, sorry, plus 2 J cap minus 8 K cap. A vector minus B vector is how much?
4 I cap.
Yes.
4 J.
Minus 4 J cap plus 2 K cap, right? So let's find out what is A vector plus B vector dot A vector minus B vector. That will be 24 minus 8 minus 16. So 24 minus 24 will give you 0. Hence, these two vectors are perpendicular to each other. Here. So this is the 15th question. Now 16th is, find the projection of A vector on B vector. B vector is I cap plus 2J cap plus K cap. Okay. So projection is given like this. So projection of A vector on B vector is equal to A vector dot B vector divided by magnitude of B vector. I told you, know, whatever is there after this on, we need to write it. So in this case, A vector dot B vector will be 2 plus 6 plus 2 divided by magnitude of B vector is square root of 1 plus 4 plus 1. Ten divided by root 6 or this can be written as 10 root 6 divided by 6. That will be 5 by 3 times root 6. So 5 by 3 times root 6 units. Here. So I'm going to the next problem. find magnitude of A vector minus B vector if two vectors A vector and B vector are such that magnitude of A is 2, magnitude of B is 3, and A dot B is equal to 4. Okay. So these kind of problems, what you need to do is observe. When you have magnitude of A vector minus B vector and other magnitudes are given along with the dot product between them, sometimes they will give you directly, they will directly give you the dot product, or they will give you the angle between both. Okay. To find this, what you need to do is you need to square on both sides. You need to consider mod of A vector minus B vector square. Okay. So mod of A vector minus B vector square is nothing but, remember, A vector minus B vector is also some other vector. I told you, no? If you have the magnitude of some vector square, then what is the meaning of this? What is the meaning of magnitude of A vector square? That is
A vector. Square.
No. It is the dot product of that vector with itself. Okay. This is what you need to remember. It's not A square. So it means here it is A vector minus B vector dot A vector minus B vector. Am I clear with this step? This is a very, very, very important step. Am I clear with this? Most of them get stuck with this.
Yes, sir.
Now listen. So you have two terms here, two terms here. Observe. So A vector dot A vector minus A vector dot B vector minus B vector dot A vector plus B vector dot B vector. So A vector dot A vector is magnitude of A vector square minus A vector dot B vector is same as B dot A. We already discussed this. It follows commutative law. Right? So can I write it as minus 2 times A vector dot B vector plus magnitude of B vector is square, since A vector dot B vector is same as B vector dot A vector. So what is magnitude of A vector square? That is 4 minus 2 times A vector dot B vector will be 4 plus magnitude of B vector square is 3 square. That is going to be 9. So 13 minus 8, answer will be 5. Done?
Sir, it is root 5, sir.
Sorry?
Root 5.
Sorry. This magnitude of A vector minus B vector square, right? Thank you. So, which implies magnitude of A vector minus B vector will be, it is root 5. Don't write it as plus or minus because magnitude is always positive. So I'm going to the next part, sir. Listen. If A vector is a unit vector, means its magnitude is 1, and x minus A vector dot x vector plus A vector is 8, find the magnitude of x vector. So will you guys try? Try it out, don't look at the solution. So how to do? So magnitude of A vector is 1. So X vector minus A vector dot X vector plus A vector. What is it? So magnitude of X vector square minus
magnitude of A vector
square. A vector square.
2 times X vector dot A vector.
Sir, it will get cancelled, sir.
Yeah, sorry. A plus B into A minus B, right? Minus magnitude of A vector square is 8. So magnitude of X vector square minus 1 will be 8, which implies magnitude of X vector square is how much?
9.
It's 3. Right? So it will be 3. Now see, 19th one. For any two vectors, A vector and B vector, we always have magnitude of A vector. Magnitude of A vector dot B vector is less than or equal to magnitude of A vector into magnitude of B vector. See, this is a very, very simple concept. Now listen. We know that A vector dot B vector is equal to magnitude of A vector into magnitude of B vector into cos theta. See, this Cauchy-Schwarz inequality is not there in your syllabus. They've just mentioned what is the name of this inequality. Our work is to prove it. Okay, let's look at it like inequality only. Don't worry about the name. Okay. So now see, taking modulus on both sides, because there was magnitude of A vector dot B vector. Okay. So if I take modulus on both sides, can I write magnitude of A vector dot B vector is equal to magnitude of A vector into B vector times cos theta, or magnitude of cos theta. Can I put it like this? So magnitude of A vector's magnitude is magnitude of A vector into magnitude of B vector cos theta. I hope it is clear till this step. Yes or no? So cos theta will be equal to magnitude of A vector in this case, magnitude of A vector dot magnitude of B vector divided by, okay, this modulus of cos theta, have this in your mind, divided by magnitude of A vector into magnitude of B vector. Now the question is, what is the maximum value cos theta can take? Cos theta, yes, it is less than or equal to 1. And what is the least value it can take?
0.
Minus 1. Because you have value between minus 1 to cos theta. Right? Whereas, if I take modulus on both the sides, modulus of cos theta will definitely be less than or equal to 1. But it will be greater than or equal to what?
0.
It will be greater than or equal to 0. Since you have modulus of cos theta here, can I write it as modulus of A vector dot B vector by magnitude of A vector into magnitude of B vector is always less than or equal to 1. Accepted. I've used this property. I've taken this right side part. So from this, if I do the necessary rearrangement, magnitude of A vector dot magnitude of B vector is always less than or equal to magnitude of A vector into make a note of this.
1 minute. Done, sir.
Let's do the next one. For any two vectors, A vector plus B vector, we always have. So they're asking us to prove. Okay. So we need to prove that for any two vectors, A vector and B vector, we have magnitude of A vector plus B vector. Is less than or equal to magnitude of A vector plus magnitude of B vector. Okay, so how to prove it? Observe, if this is A vector and this is B vector, then this will be A vector plus B vector, right? So if I take magnitude of A vector plus magnitude of B vector, then this is always greater than or equal to the third side, because sum of two sides will always be greater than or equal to the third side. So sum of two sides will be greater than or equal to the third side. That's the answer. Okay, this is one way to prove. Or what you can do is, if you consider A vector plus B vector square. Okay, if you consider magnitude A vector plus B vector's magnitude square, then this can be written as A vector plus B vector dot A vector plus B vector. Accepted? Right. So this will be magnitude of A vector square plus magnitude of B vector square plus 2ab cos theta. Yes, yes or no? Guys, are you clear or not?
Yes, sir.
So, they are asking, so you need the whole square of it. Okay. So, let me try this. Cos theta is less than or equal to 1, greater than or equal to minus 1. This we know, right? So, multiplying with 2ab on both the sides, minus 2ab is less than or equal to 2ab cos theta is less than or equal to 2ab. Are you guys clear with this?
Yes, sir.
So adding modulus of a square plus b square on both sides, what do we get? Magnitude of a vector square plus magnitude of b vector square minus 2ab is less than or equal to magnitude of a vector square plus magnitude of b vector square plus 2ab cos theta is less than or equal to magnitude of a vector square plus magnitude of b vector square plus 2 times ab. Are you guys clear? You understood what I did? So I started with the basic property of cos. Cos is less than or equal to 1, greater than or equal to minus 1. So when you multiply the 2ab on both the sides, this is what you're going to get. Then adding a square plus b square on both the sides, this is the expression you will be getting. Am I right? Now tell me one thing. What is a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta? From 1, a square plus b square plus 2ab cos theta is nothing but magnitude of A vector plus magnitude of B vector square. is less than or equal to, what is a square plus b square plus 2ab?
A plus b whole square.
So magnitude of a vector plus magnitude of b vector, the whole square. Remember, everything is a positive value. So when you take the square root on both the sides, can I conclude that magnitude of a vector plus b vector is less than or equal to magnitude of a vector plus b vector? So that's what they've asked us to do. So I've done it in both the methods. Depending on the marks, you have to choose. This is a one mark one problem. You can do it using the first method. Anything other than one mark, you need to solve using the second. Make a note of this. I hope you're done. Okay. Now, they're asking us to see, look at the 21st example. They're asking us to prove that these three points are collinear. So, collinear means the angle between them is going to be 0 degrees, right? So, when A vector is given, it means OA vector is given. So, OA vector is minus 2i cap plus 3j cap plus 5k cap, because A is a point. A point will have a position vector with respect to origin. Similarly, what is OB vector? I cap plus 2j cap plus 3k cap. What is OC vector? That is 7i cap minus k cap. So if you have to prove that AB and BC or AC, all these are collinear, find out what is AB vector. So, AB vector is equal to OB vector minus OA vector. I told you what is the relation between a vector and its position vectors. I hope you remember this, guys. So, it is final position vector minus initial position vector. So, that will be, how much is it? 3i cap minus j cap minus 2k. So, 3i cap minus j cap minus 2k cap is the AB vector. Similarly, can you tell me what is BC vector?
6i cap.
Huh?
6i cap.
Yes. Minus 2j cap. Minus 4k cap. Okay. Similarly, what is AC vector? We'll find all the three, okay? AC vector is OC vector minus OA vector. What is OC vector minus OA? That is 6i cap, not 6. How much
nine,
is this?
9i cap.
9i cap minus 3j cap minus 6k cap. That is AC vector. Accept it. A question is, observe, in this, if I take out 3 common, then it will be 3i cap minus j cap minus 2k cap. In this, if I take out 2 common, that will be 3i cap minus j cap minus 2k cap. If you observe one thing, AB vector, sorry. BC vector is equal to 2 times AB vector and AC vector is equal to 2 times 3 times AB vector. So if one vector is lambda times another, then those two vectors are collinear. And in that collinearity, look at the points A, B and C are involved. Hence, we can say that the points A, B, C are collinear. Did you guys understand what I did?
Yes.
This is one of the methods only. I'm not saying this is only method. This is one of the methods. Okay. What is the alternate method? Can someone tell me? So the alternate method is find the angle between AB vector and AC vector. Okay. This part I'm leaving it to you. If you get the angle as 0 degrees or 180 degrees, you can say that these two vectors are collinear. So this part I'm leaving it to you. Moving on to the next part. So listen, find the angle between the two vectors A vector and B vector whose magnitudes are root 3 and 2 respectively, having A vector dot B vector is equal to root 6. It's very simple again. Cos theta is equal to A vector dot B vector divided by magnitude of A vector into magnitude of B vector. That will be root 6 divided by root 3 into 2. That will be root 2 by 2. Answer will be 1 by root 2. So theta will be cos inverse of 1 by root 2. Answer is pi by 4. So that is pi by 4. So it's a simple one. Moving on to the next one. Similar homework. Projection homework. This A vector, this B vector. Formula is A vector dot B vector by magnitude of B vector. 4th homework. This A vector, this B vector. Show that each of the given three vectors is a unit vector. That's very easy to prove. If I take this as A vector, B vector and C vector, for us to prove that it is a unit vector, what are we supposed to do? We need to prove that magnitude of A vector is same as magnitude of B vector is same as C vector, which is equal to 1. So I'll find for magnitude of, I'll find for A vector. So I'm taking 1 by 7 into square root of 4 plus 9 plus 36, that will be square root of 49 divided by 7, answer will be 1. Right? So it's simple. Also, show that they are mutually perpendicular to each other. Mutually in the sense, A is perpendicular to B, B is perpendicular to C, and A is also perpendicular to C. So for that, what we need to do is, we need to prove A vector dot B vector is 0. B vector dot C vector is 0 and A vector dot C vector is 0. We need to prove that, right? So what is A dot B? That will be 6 minus 18 plus 12, the whole divided by 49. If you observe, it is 0. Okay. Similarly, I hope your people can do it between B dot C and A dot C. Right?
Yes, sir.
Go to the next problem. Find A vector and B vector. If A vector plus B vector dot A vector minus B vector is 8, magnitude of A vector is equal to 8 times B vector. So these are all given to us. So if this is the data given to us, we need to find what is the magnitude of A vector and B vector. So when you do the dot product, what are you going to get? A vector dot A vector minus A vector dot B vector plus B vector dot A vector minus B vector dot B vector. So that is magnitude of A vector square minus magnitude of 2 times A vector dot B vector minus magnitude of B vector square. Okay, this is given as 8. So what is magnitude of A vector?
Minus 2A vector, they will be cancelled now, sir.
So they are cancelled, okay.
Yes, sir.
So minus magnitude of B vector square is equal to 8. Now it's fine, right? Oh, I think it is easy, right? They are given magnitude of A vector is 8 times B vector. So 64 times magnitude of B vector square minus magnitude of B vector square is equal to 8. Correct? Yes. So 63 times magnitude of B vector square is 8, which implies magnitude of B vector is how much? 8 divided by 63 under a root. Then what will be A vector? 8 times root 8 divided by 8. Done?
Yes, sir.
Okay. We'll go to the next one. So I think the question is So evaluate the dot product. So it is 6 times A vector dot A vector minus 21 times A vector dot B vector minus 10 times B vector dot A vector minus 35 times magnitude of B vector square. So 6A square minus 12 A vector dot B vector minus 35 B square. So this is the required answer. Right. Now going to the next problem. So this will be the last problem for the day. Find the magnitude of two vectors, A vector and B vector, having the same magnitude. So solution. What is given? magnitude of A vector is equal to magnitude of B vector, and theta is equal to 60 degrees, and their scalar product is half. Scalar product is half. That is A vector dot B vector is equal to half. And it should be 1. So magnitude of A vector is equal to magnitude of B vector. Let's call it as A itself. So what is the basic definition of A vector dot B vector? It is magnitude of A into magnitude of B into cos theta is equal to half. Right? So magnitude of A and magnitude of B are the same. So A square into, what is the value of cos theta, guys? Cos 60 is equal to half. But what is cos 60? It is half. This and this will get cancelled, which implies magnitude of A square is 1. This is the same as magnitude of B also. So A and B are what vectors?
Unit vector.
Okay. So this is how the problems will be. You can try the remaining 10 problems. Okay. Next class, first 15 minutes, I'll clear your doubts and we'll go to the next exercise. With that, this chapter is over. By next class, we can complete it. Okay. So just wait for a minute, don't log off.